Welcome back to Spillo Tutorial Services. Today we're going to talk about direct and indirect variation that come together in a single problem. That would be depicted as the following equation, y equals k times x divided by z. So again, we see that x is the direct variation, and we see that being divided by z, that there's the inverse or indirect variation. All right, so let's start with this problem. The number of minutes needed to solve math problems varies directly as the number of problems and inversely as the number of people working on those problems. So the number of minutes needed to solve the problem, that there is going to be depicted as y. We see it says that it varies directly as the number of people. The number of people we're going to call x, and inversely as the number of people working on those problems. So the number of people is going to be z. Our second sentence, it takes 4 people 32 minutes to solve 16 problems. Well, we know y corresponds to the minutes, so that's going to be 32. We're trying to find the constant of variation. We see that x corresponds to the number of problems. They told us here that it's 16 problems. And lastly, we see that z is the number of people, and they told us that it is 4 people. Now we break this down to solve for k. Well, 16 divided by 4. Is 4, so I have 4k, and I bring down my 32, and to isolate the k, I divide both sides by 4, so here I have that 8 equals k, so I have my constant of variation. Now I go back and I solve for what they're asking. They want to know how many minutes, they want to know how many minutes it will take 8 people to solve 24 problems. Well, the minutes corresponds to y, as we see up here. We have k, which is the constant of variation, which is 8. Now we need to find x. X is the number of problems. Here they said it is 24 problems, and we need to divide that by z, and z is the number of people, and here we see that they have 8 people. Now we just break down this expression. I have factors of 8 in the numerator and denominator, so they cancel, and here I see that y is 24. So what that means is that it will take those people 24 minutes to solve those problems. All right, that sums it up for this video by Spillo Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel to see our new and plenty of our previous videos on various math topics. Thank you again for watching.